Hair and makeup.
So you guys, when you walk up, can just walk up to where my key is.
Okay. Is that going to be like 5 minutes or sooner?
No. Sorry, yeah. I thought it was happening now. Once the video starts, it's going to be like less than a minute.
Do we know when the video will start?
No. She walked away and I don't know. But, Alright, so I walk over now. Hey guys, how's it going? We're KiiK.
I'm Manuela.
And I'm Gray.
We're here painting two of the courts of the Norman Jean Reed Park for the US Open 50th anniversary.
This is an art court project.
This morning we painted with a few of the kids who are going to be playing on these courts, so it was cool to meet them. And Norman Jean Reed Park, painting two tennis courts for the US Open's 50th anniversary. We were painting this morning with some of the kids who are going to be playing tennis on these courts, and they came by to meet us and to tell us a little bit about their practice and how dedicated they are to the sport. Some of them practice almost every day, so it was cool to talk to them and have them help us out painting part of our court. Our piece is called Infinity Love.
Or Love Infinity. It's just sort of a play on words, talking about the, you know, how you keep score in tennis, using the word love. And we also think, you know, a lot of people play with a lot of love and a lot of passion, and, you know, that's what we bring to our art. We bring a lot of love. It's all about, you know, high vibrations and, you know, bringing, you know, love and positivity to
our work. We're from KiiK, so our brand talks a lot about creating uplifting experiences and bringing high vibrations and love and positivity to the area that we activate with our artwork. So we're really excited to have the opportunity to collaborate here and bring some of that high energy to the tennis courts. I think this is the first time that tennis courts are intervening with art, so it's really cool that we get to inspire and remind kids to really follow their passion and to commit and bring a lot of love to their practice, whether it be art, whether it be music, whether it be in this case tennis. But for us, our artwork and our practice is a lot to just tune out the noise and to tune in to the high vibration and to follow with your heart whatever inspires you to be a better person or to make a change in your own life or in other people's life and kind of just be uplifting and a positive person and living a positive life.
Yeah, we think that there's infinite love out there, and that's what we want to spread with this particular piece here on the art courts.
So right now we're finished with half of our court, the love side, and it's kind of a play on the heart shape with the application of stripes and patterning that we're doing with our artwork. And then the other half of the court that we're excited to reveal on the 14th during the inauguration is the infinity symbol. So we're going to start with that tomorrow, so hopefully you can tune in and check that out, how we start from scratch to filling in with color.
Yeah, thanks for joining us here, guys, and, you know, keep following along the progress, and we'll keep you tuned with all the other new updates.
No. We're gonna do some video again, and then I'll probably cut to you.
Okay,
I don't
worry. Alright, it's... Nobody's worried about drips. I don't care about drips. Am I not the ANAL person that's supposed to worry about drips? I'm not worried about drips at all. Not in the slug shit. So let's just say, like, gray is in the slug. Gray or...
Are you guys ready?
When you think of return to serve, what comes to mind?
Having fun.
Thank you, USTA. Thank you, USTA.
Thank you.
local level.
Grew up playing in an NJTL program, and I know how important it is for kids to have an outlet that really stresses education, education being the key. That's the reason I think education was so important for me and hopefully for the next generation.
In celebration of the 50th anniversary of the U.S. Open in the open era, the USTA, in partnership with Chase, will build upon its shared mission to strengthen communities through tennis by restoring 5 public tennis facilities across the country. Each court facility will be defined by a theme that captures the vibe of the local community, resulting in a breathtaking demonstration of creativity and culture that will serve to inspire and excite our National Junior Tennis and Learning, NJTL Network. The NJTL Network is committed to delivering tennis and educational programs to underserved communities.
When I became the president of the USTA, my goals for the USTA Foundation were really serving as many youth as possible, providing them opportunities to play our sport while advancing themselves with their education.
trim on that red?
Don't touch the trim.
No?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no.
Can I do it?
Okay. You should be able to stand in that pink by now, yeah.
Well, I just painted some of it.
The pink?
Oh, yeah, no.
Be able to stand in the pink right now.
Okay.
That is quite expensive.
Look at your shoes. How's working up the ring?
That's me. I did that.
Oh.
That's when I was on the wheelie cart.
I thought you were talking about.
What's working with this brush?
It dropped and I tore. I just said that. I said it's good. I thought you were worried that my shoes had paint.
Am I dripping right now? Or did I get all the drips?
purple. The section next to you.
Yeah.
What about that?
Daisy plain blue.
Both of those?
Oh, that is the light. The lavender. Just filling the blue, that'll get caught with the red.
Yeah, this red makes it tough.
It's like make sure you have all the blue filled and then go back and do it.
This red also here. Thank you.
Yeah, I had that thought that we could have made half that green, the light green.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Manuel.
Hi, I'm Sophia.
I'm Anaya.
And I represent First Serve Miami.
It's the 50th anniversary of the U.S. Open, and they're giving us an art court.
We were very excited when we were selected to be a part of the U.S. Open Art Courts in conjunction with Chase.
I've never seen anything like it, and I think the kids are going to go crazy once they see it.
First Serve Miami became a National Junior Tennis and Learning chapter last year.
First Serve started in 1974 here in Miami. We were very fortunate to have great leaders in terms of Arthur Ashe.
Now we have the backing of USTA to make our program what we've always wanted it to be, tennis and learning. They learn how to wait your turn, how to respect your teammate. You know, we're doing now STEM with them. So within the courts, we're teaching them about technology and mathematics.
When you're playing with other people, you have to trust them. They have to trust you. You have more communication involved. I really wanted to play with other people. It was a lot of money coming out my mom's pocket. And I got sponsored.
The first time I picked up a racket, I was a little surprised. I was like, how do you break this thing?
Just the growth of our program has been outstanding. Wherever we go, the kids really want to participate.
My favorite U.S. Open champion is Roger Federer. He's always giving back to kids, and I think that's what's awesome about him.
I'm really inspired by U.S. Open champion Sloane Stephens, because we can have our highest high and our lowest lows, but in the end, we know we can fight hard and win it.
We are making a significant difference here. Through our Adopt a Player program, we have been very fortunate having 47 of 48 kids go to college on full or part-time scholarships.
Thank you, U.S. Open and Chase, for bringing the art project to Miami.
idea of like staying later. Yeah, I'm gonna try to spread this as much as I can. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in with us today. Stay tuned tomorrow. I hope to let you in a little bit more of the process as we start our second court. And yeah, like I said, thanks for keeking it with us. Peace. Night, y'all.